England Lions slipped to a 22-run defeat against the New Zealanders in Bristol to make it one win and one loss thus far in the triangular A-team series. That in spite of a brilliant 100 from Jonny Bairstow and 5 for 62 from David Willey. BJ Watling won the toss and decided to have a bat first, but Willey struck with his fifth ball by bowling Tom Latham for a single, the batsman choosing the wrong delivery to leave alone. But Anton Devsich and Dean Brownlie then made very good progress through the rest of the power play overs after the former got away with this nick. Stephen Finn, who just missed out on the final 11 for the Old Trafford Test match, went for 33 runs in his first five overs, while Willey's opening four cost 27. Craig Overton was brought on to bowl the 10th over of the match, and with his third delivery, he had Devsich held in the slips by Tom Smith, the batsman leaving having made 24. The score read 65 for 2 at the end of the power play, and in the 15th over, Brownlie, who has played a handful of tests and ODIs for the national team, reached a 50 off 43 balls, getting there with his 11th four. He looked in fine form, and in over number 18, he cleared the rope for the first time off Overton with a pickup shot over Cow Corner. He was well backed up by Grant Elliott, a 35-year-old who's represented his country more than 50 times in the one-day arena. He kept Brownlie company for 16 overs, in which 73 runs were added for the third wicket, Elliott making 42 of them. Just into the second half of the innings, he then had a horrible hack at a ball from Smith and was bowled with a total on 137 for 3. Colin Munro, who's played a few T20 games for Worcestershire this summer, was also bowled by a full-length delivery from Willey to leave the Kiwis on 175 for 4 with 19 overs remaining. They would have been hopeful of a total of around 300 but were set back as they also lost Colin de Granton for 5, Alex Hales with the catch at deep backward square off Finn. And when Watling was the third man to be bowled by Willey, New Zealand were struggling a bit on 194 for 6. The fact that they got as far as 282 had much to do with Brownlie, who reached a fine 100 off only 97 deliveries. He struck 15 fours and 1 6 in a top knock, which was giving his side a chance of posting something competitive on a slow surface at Neville Road. He celebrated by fetching a short-ish ball from Smith over the rope for his second maximum. The 30-year-old's innings was finally brought to an end by Smith on 115, Willey with a catch at long on that left the Kiwis on 238 for 7, with 8 overs left to score from. Willey gave a rather modest assessment of his performance after the match. His fourth wicket arrived when Scott Kugelein pulled out to Smith after making a useful 33. Doug Bracewell then threw the bat to be caught at deep extra by Hales on 15. And New Zealand were all out off the final ball as Matt Henry was run out by James Taylor after an initial misfield, Willey ending an excellent time in the field by completing the dismissal, as the visitors were all out for 282, Willey ending with figures of 5 for 62. The Lions would have fancied chasing that down, but they lost too many wickets early on, starting with the one of James Vince, who was LBW to Henry for 1 in the third over. Henry struck again in the 7th, Hales unable to repeat his heroics of a couple of days before as he pulled the bowler to Munro, who held on well. Hales made 7 and his Nottinghamshire teammate Taylor was out for the same score. Bracewell, a famous name in these parts because of his uncle John, with the wicket as the batsman failed to keep his pull shot down. 3 balls later and Ravi Bapara was also on his way with an edge behind, which left the Lions in some trouble on 48 for 4 in over number 13. The top order had set up the win over the Sri Lankans in Taunton on Wednesday, but now it was up to the middle order to shine with the bat. In spite of the situation, Jason Roy and Bairstow played freely as they just started to forge an important partnership. Roy, of course, smashed 5 sixes in an over in that win the other day, and he again produced some stunning cricket shots. Few can have a bat speed as quick as his, It was almost as if he was auditioning for the part of Zorro with strokes like this. He'd added 95 runs in 16 and a half overs with Bairstow when the Surrey man perished on 42, although it took an excellent catch at mid-wicket by Latham to get rid of him. Bairstow, however, remained, and this single took him to his second successive half-century in this competition. He'd needed 62 deliveries for this one, an innings which was keeping his side in with a shout of making it two wins from two. Thus far, he'd hit five fours. With Smith producing some magic at the other end, the 200 was brought up in the 39th over, and with Bairstow picking up the pace, moving into the 80s, it looked as if we were going to have a nerve-jangling end to this game between two evenly matched teams. But two wickets in the space of three overs then knocked the Lions back. On 20, Smith went for something big and was bowled by Bracewell, who then came off and watched Willey top edge a slog sweep to be caught in the deep to leave the Lions needing 68 to win off 48 balls with only three wickets in hand. That became two just two balls later as Overton stuttered mid-pitch and was run out, much to the disappointment of Bairstow, who was now into the 90s. So it was up to him now to try to win this game for his country, although Finn showed that he knows one end of a bat from the other by clearing the rope with this shot. He hit the next ball for 4-2 before in the 45th over, Bairstow also went the distance off the returning Bracewell, a remarkable shot that headed towards the new flats at this newly developed ground. Next ball and the Yorkshireman was at his 100. It was a fantastic knock from a man who last played a one-day international for England in September 2012. After getting to three figures off 103 balls with nine fours and that 1-6, he must fancy being part of the squad which heads for the World Cup down under in the winter. This inning certainly stood apart from the rest on this day. And he hadn't given up winning this game yet. 46 were required off the final five overs and Bairstow pummeled Henry for this six and a four off successive deliveries to bring that target down to 33 off 24 balls. But then Bairstow rather sold Finn short, wanting to keep the strike for as much as possible. The direct hit from mid-off sending the Middlesex man on his way for 11. With Ravi Patel the last man in with 32 needed, Bairstow needed to go it alone. But having added nine more, he drilled a ball from Henry to cover where a fine catch was completed. Bairstow was out for 123, made off 116 balls as the Lions were dismissed for 260. That meant a defeat by 22 runs, a pretty good effort in the end, after losing their top four with just 48 runs on the board. The competition now moves to Worcester, where the Lions are next in action on Monday. That's after the Sri Lankans and New Zealand do battle in Bristol on Saturday.